Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to do a top 10 of movies I like. And so many people have asked me to do like a list of my top 10, here's what I like. But that's Jeff's thing, I'm not going to intrude on Jeff. He's working that very successfully on Instagram at the moment. So I'm not going to intrude on that, but I am going to show a top 10 of just movies off the top of my shelf here that I would go for and gravitate towards. And obviously the first one I've got to take off, I'm going to do it like a Criterion thing. So, you know, I kind of like, you know how Criterion shoot their things and like, okay, I'm going to look through the collection and take it off as I'm going. But the number one I always pick and I always gravitate towards when I want to watch a movie is Titanic. And it's obvious that it's my favorite movie. But also, I really like this transfer of Titanic. It's really great on 4K. And I think that overall, look, Titanic is a thing that I grew up hearing about, and I didn't see it in cinemas, but I watched it a lot when it came to VHS. Like, I was renting that thing weekly almost. And it was such a culturally significant movie in terms of what it meant to the world cinema and what it meant to cinema overall. Like, it's nothing sold more tickets than Titanic overall. Like, maybe Gone with the Wind, but since then nothing has come close to selling tickets. Not money, revenue raised, because ticket prices went up year after year. Nothing sold more tickets than Titanic other than maybe Gone with the Wind. Like, I think it was like 50 million, 60 million tickets overall sold at cinemas. And you might say, oh, but you know, so-and-so broke its box office record. It made more money, but Titanic sold more tickets. More people were there watching it in the cinemas. But yeah, I absolutely love Titanic. Everyone who watches the channel knows I absolutely gravitate towards Titanic. And likewise, I also gravitate towards, where is it? Here it is. Jurassic Park. The first Jurassic Park movie is amazing as well. Like, I absolutely love how, like, I grew up on dinosaurs. So it's like, everywhere was Jurassic Park at a certain point, especially 95. And, you know, you grow up on Jurassic Park and love it. But I didn't really like the sequels all that much. I mean, I liked parts of them. I can watch them. They're definitely good movies. I like them. But like Jurassic Park, the first one with Steven Spielberg directing, and like, I think he directed Last World though. I think he directed them too, but the good one, the one everyone talks about, the good one. I absolutely love Jurassic Park. It's one of those movies that, look, I've heard the Laserdisc is the best way to watch it in terms of sound. DTS is obviously a much cleaner, a much more authentic version of Jurassic Park. And if you're watching it, you kind of want to have the more authentic version. You want to have something that's like DTS sound. And they haven't really ported that Laserdisc version on, in terms of sound, onto the Blu-ray. So that's missing here, or 4K. But the visuals are so beautiful and so good that I absolutely love this movie on 4K. So that's two so far. Number three I actually want to talk about is, where is it over here? Shawshank Redemption. I tend to gravitate towards Shawshank Redemption quite a lot. And it's one of the best movies of all time. I mean, call it what it is. It's based on a book. It's originally Rita Hayworth and The Shawshank Redemption. But this is, in my view, one of the best movies ever made. Like, it is so amazingly made. And everything that happens in the movie, if you haven't seen it, I'm not going to talk too much about the plot or anything that happens. Obviously, I'll just mention Andy Dufresne gets convicted of a murder that we don't really know if he's guilty or innocent of. He claims he's innocent, but he's put in Shawshank State Prison. And throughout the movie, you learn things about Andy and what he can do. And that is, the movie plays out, you start to learn more things and start to understand what's happened. And one of the best movies of all time. Love The Shawshank Redemption. And that's a movie I gravitate towards. I gravitate towards that one. When I go for movie night, I'm like, I tend to stick to my favorites. I watch a lot from the movie collection as well, but sometimes you want to watch something new and I'll go like, okay, I want to watch a whatever. But I will usually gravitate towards Shawshank Redemption or Titanic or, you know, Jurassic Park. Or where's the other one? There's another one here that I gravitate towards. Maybe over here. Where did I put it? I will find it right now. Give me 2 seconds. It's probably in drama. Yeah, it's in drama. I don't know why I didn't look in drama first. Jaws. I've mentioned it from time to time. Jaws is one of those movies that really just grabs you and really, I mean, grabs you literally in the movie. But like, it's one of those movies that just keep keeps on. Its impact overall is so good that, like, it has stayed the test of time. And even the animatronic shark in this is like, it holds up after so many years. Nothing has come close to the original Jaws in terms of impact. Like, there are still times when you can put on this movie and people will still sell out of cinema. And for that reason, it's going to be in my top 10 today. And, you know, my top 10 is going to change from time to time. Obviously, movies I stale on here and there, I might stop watching them for a period of time, but it usually rotates between certain movies. So this is my, obviously, I'm going to be doing a top 10 for this point in time, the movies I gravitate towards when I want to watch a movie. So another movie I gravitate towards and I watch quite a bit of is, I don't know exactly where it is. I think there it is. Let me just see if I can get it out. My DC collection's packed pretty tight because I'm trying to make room. The Dark Knight, like, could you ask any more? Like, The Dark Knight is one of those movies that is so perfect. And I know people say, but it has this flaw, it has that flaw. It's almost so perfect that I'm just like, I am at that level of, well, why wouldn't I just gravitate towards that when I want to watch DC? DC has that reputation of being not too good. I mean, you got Man of Steel and all that stuff in there, but I mean, this is a really, really good movie. Like, it's the best DC's done in a long time. And I know they've done Justice League, the Snyder Cut, but you have to keep in mind Snyder Cut wasn't originally a thing. This was the original impact, and this is freaking awesome. So for that reason, it's going in my top... That's five right now. That's my top five that I think off the top of my head. They're five I gravitate towards so much. I also gravitated quite a lot towards The Martian for some reason. I don't know what it is about The Martian. Maybe it's that whole dilemma of, like, what would happen. I mean, look, people can laugh at this movie and call it a comedy or whatever. I've got both versions of it, by the way. I've got one with Deadpool on the cover. But I absolutely love The Martian. I think I can watch both versions. I can watch the cinema version or I can watch the extended version. That's why I have two versions of it. But I absolutely love this movie. I think it really gets in mind thinking of, like, what would I do if I was isolated on a planet away from everyone and had to watch Happy Days every day? I mean, I'll probably love it, but, you know, it's kind of like the mindset of, like, you put yourself in the character of, Mark Watney, it's Mark Watney, yeah? That's his character's name? I feel it's Mark Watney. I don't know if it's on the cover, but, yeah, anyways, Ridley Scott did a really good, it just says American Astronaut, but I think it's Mark Watney, but Ridley Scott did a really good job with this. It's one of Ridley Scott's more stronger films in recent decades. I mean, say what you will about Ridley, he has hits and misses, but most of the time he gets it right, and, you know, sometimes it doesn't do as well as he believes, but I actually like The Martian. I feel like it's one of those respectable Ridley Scott movies. It kind of brings me to it. So that's going as number 6 in my collection right now, and these aren't ordered in any way. I'm just going towards whatever my mind thinks at the time, so that's number 6 right now, but, you know, I could move it up, could move it down, depending on the night. Now, number 7 is a bit of a weird one. I'm trying to find if I can actually pick one out here, because I had the first 6 planned out. Now I'm going to go towards what would I actually gravitate towards. And look, when I look at my Blu-ray collection, I'm constantly like, okay, what do I want to watch? And I have such a huge choice of movies that's kind of like, okay, what do I actually want to watch? Like, there's so much to choose from. I mean, I go back here and I look at, like, the comedy section and it's like, okay, I might watch a bit of, South Park. I might watch a bit of Shrek, you know. There's so much in this collection to just choose from. And I'm going towards 4K for this video, so obviously I didn't mention it in the video, but it will be in the title that these are my 4K picks. I'll do a separate Blu-ray pick, but also, you know, I don't really want to make it too diluted by saying get DVDs and then get Blu-ray and then put it all in and then that. I just want to do a 4K so people know 4Ks I'm actually watching. So yeah, number 7 is a bit of a hard one because I planned out the first 6, except I just saw number 7. Matrix. I got to put the Matrix in there. I have watched this movie so many times, and especially with the 4K, because the color grade, they got rid of that horrendous color grade with the green that they put on it in the Blu-ray. It's back to the original color grade, and it's like, the Matrix did not look like that initially. It looked like, it didn't have green color grade. It looked like more like this. And it's just amazing to have a movie that looks this good, shot in, like, what, 1999, because it came out in, like, 2000 or something. 99, yeah. It was shot in 99, was released in 2000? Or might have been released in 99. Either way. Matrix has to be in my collection. It's one of my go-tos. It's one of the ones that I constantly, like, gravitate towards. If I'm, like, bored, I'll be like, oh, I could just watch The Matrix. And I'll usually just watch The Matrix, you know? It's like one of those movies that I just gravitate towards. But yeah, now it's getting more difficult. So what have we got now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we need to pick three more. And this is where it gets hard. Down the bottom end of this video, it's harder to pick because you've got most of your favorites now. You've kind of drawn from the collection and you're kind of now at the dilemma of like, okay, I maybe could put Indiana Jones there, but that's probably a once a year watch. It's, you know, like I'm trying to go for the ones that I would usually gravitate towards and usually pick up and usually put in my player. Although I just found another one and I will bring it out right now because it's one of my favorites of all time. I was basically raised on it. Blues Brothers. You can't go wrong with the Blues Brothers. I mean, if you just want a music night, you can put on this, movie and just enjoy the music of it. Like, you can go to the actual musical numbers and jump back and forth between them. I think they have a musical version of that on there. But it's just so good. It's like to just switch off and watch the Blues Brothers. And I was raised on this. Like, I was raised on the VHS of this. So, like, to watch it look this good on 4K and watch it do justice, yeah. Blues Brothers has to be in here. So that's number 8, I believe. Now we've got two more to fill. And this is the hard part. Because now I feel like I actually have got everything. I'm going to put Interstellar in there. I'm going to put Interstellar as number 9. Because Interstellar is actually a really good movie. And I tend to gravitate towards that quite a bit as well. Obviously, Matt Damon in space. Obviously, it feels a bit similar to another movie. But like, you know, I love this movie because Nolan just knows how to deliver. I feel like I gravitate more and more towards a Nolan movie. Now, I used to gravitate towards Jim Cameron movies, but at a certain point, I don't know, I kind of stalled on Cameron because he wasn't really making anything. I mean, I could say Terminator 2, but obviously I'm not the biggest fan of that 4K transfer. I mean, that might play into my Blu-ray collection of like movies I gravitate towards, but definitely not a 4K I gravitate towards. I watch Terminator like 2 or 3 times a year, but it's mostly the Blu-ray version because I can't watch the DVD at the 4K because it just feels too off. But yeah, Nolan has slowly become my favorite director, and I think Interstellar is one of those movies that I'm just like, it is so perfect, this movie. And I know people will say, but it's not perfect for this reason. It didn't do that and didn't do this. But to have a movie shot on film, it's just, it's going as number 9 in my collection. So I've got 9 right now. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we've got to find one more, guys. We've got to find one more of the top 10 4K Blu-rays of right now in my, as I gravitate towards. I mean, I could choose The Crow, but I haven't watched the 4K transfer of The Crow yet. I have to watch that at some point. I mean, it is one of my favorites, so I probably should watch it. I mean, there are lots in my collection. There's so much to draw from that it's kind of difficult to actually just say, okay, Back to the Future or like The Abyss. I haven't watched that more than once. So I'm going towards ones I've watched more than once, which is the hard part. Obviously, I do know one, and I will end on this. It's actually a two movie thing. So I have to go like, you can't watch one without the other. And I've watched it at least like twice or three times a year because I have to do them back to back if I'm going to do them. It's in my Marvel collection. You kind of might understand where I'm going with this. The absolute best the MCU had to offer at that time. Like, Infinity War and Endgame were so perfect together. If you don't have to watch any of the MCU, like, let's say you're just new to Marvel and you're like, I don't really care about the 22 movie build-up or whatever it was. I just want to watch a good superhero movie. I would put on Infinity War, and then I'll put on Endgame and be like, you can go in blind. I mean, yes, it's better to have the backstory of all these characters. Don't get me wrong. You want to watch it through and watch the build of those characters. You have more initial connection to those characters. But then to see them get it so right with these two, like, these two for me are go towards. So it's going to be the top 11. I know I said this was the top 10, but it's going to be the top 11. These are the movies that gravitate towards. So just to reiterate, just go back. Titanic, Jurassic Park, Shawshank Redemption, Jaws, The Dark Knight, The Martian, Matrix, the first Matrix, that is, The Blues Brothers, Interstellar, and Infinity War, and Endgame as one as its own. So it's a one collection. You can't watch one without the other, in my view. So that's my top 10 or 11, I should call it. And yeah, they're the 4Ks that I gravitate towards. When I want to watch a 4K Blu-ray, when I want to watch something on my TV, they're the top 10 I go towards. If you enjoyed this video, let me know what you think. Like, subscribe, drop a comment, and I will catch you in the next one. These really are great, aren't they?